Hello and welcome in today's video. Today I will be discussing about what is Fresnel prism. So in this video I will be discussing about what is a Fresnel prism, how it is manufactured, how it is used into our optometry practice, what are the advantages and disadvantages. So let's start with the video and see the particular things. The first thing about optics. So what is Fresnel prism? So Fresnel prism is nothing but it is a sheet of PVC, that is polyvinyl chloride, which is converted into such a form that it will give you a particular prismatic effect. So how does a Fresnel prism works? The simple principle behind a prism is that a particular angle is formed at the apex, which is called as the apical angle. So here, if you can see, there is an apical angle which is present here, which is basically your angle between the one refractive and the other refractive side. This is what is called as the base. So traditional prisms, which are actually having an apex and a base, are comparatively quite thick. So because of this thickness, they are heavier in weight and quite cosmetically blemish. Whereas what Fresnel found out, that if a particular prismatic effect is dependent on the apical angle and the refractive index, so we need not to keep such a bigger chunk of your prism. Rather, only one small part of this complete triangle, or rather this complete prism, can be used to give the similar effect. So what they did, they made a stack of such small prisms into a row, which could give you the same desired effect. So whenever a light is incident onto any particular part, because of the same apical angle and the refractive index, it will give you the same amount of prismatic effect, which is given by the traditional prism, which is bigger in size. The advantages here, a conventional prism would be quite thicker at the base and thinner at the prism, so it would be bulky and quite thick, whereas a Fresnel prism is only 1 mm thickness. So even if it is the apex or base, so you will find out that it is hardly 1 mm in thickness, and still it gives you the same amount of prismatic effect. Also, because of it is made up of your polyvinyl chloride, it is quite flexible and easy to use. Coming on to the manufacturing, so how Fresnel prisms are manufactured. So the modern technique of manufacturing Fresnel prism is your injection molding. So in injection molding, what we do is, so this is what is called as an injection molding machine. So here there is a mold which will contain particular amount of grooves or the apical angle which is required to create a certain amount of prismatic effect. So this is where the plastic material is given into granules. So these granules are nothing but your PVC, that is polyvinyl chloride. So once they go into the injector, this barrel will heat up, which is the second process. So the heater will on, and this barrel will convert your granules into a molten plastic, and that molten plastic is poured into this particular mold, which contains the certain amount of grooves at a particular angle. So the moment you inject the complete material, then it is allowed to cool off. So plastic is very quick to cool. So suddenly when it cools, it can be detached off, and a particular amount of shape is desired, which is obtained from this procedure, and this is what is called as your injection molding. So after injection molding, what we get is something like this. So this particular area, that is your prism which will be acting. So they have a particular striation. These striations are because of your base and apex. So this is a particular Fresnel prism which you can get. So if you see, this is giving already a prismatic effect. The image which is seen from the Fresnel prism is displaced upward, so this is already giving you a prismatic effect. So here if you see, it is written 35 prism diopters. So the amount of prism which is given by this particular Fresnel prism is your 35 prism. How to apply a Fresnel prism using a water? So generally the Fresnel prism which we get are traditionally made by your 3M company. A company named as 3M makes this Fresnel prism, also called as Fresnel press-on prism. So how you apply into your spectacle, or how do you use it? So now we already understood how it is made. So let's see how it is used into your optometry practice. So let's say you have a patient who has a certain amount of squint, and you need to give a particular amount of prism. So that much amount of prism, Fresnel sheet is taken. So the Fresnel sheet would be first kept onto your spectacle frame, and then it would be marked completely. So whatever shape your lens is, you will mark it completely with a marker over your Fresnel prism. Then with the help of a sharp scissor, you cut that much amount of your part and throw out the excess. Now before marking, please, you need to look through that where exactly the base has to be placed. there is a description, or rather a particular marking given onto the Fresnel prism itself, there where the base lies. Or even if you don't find it as a marking, when you apply your nail over the groove of your Fresnel prism, you can find out which side is the base. The base would be slightly elevated and having the groove. So that would be the base direction. So once you start cutting, you should cut it completely all over your grooves and get a perfect shape of your lens. So the moment your lens shape is ready, then what you do is you apply water at the back surface of the lens. Now this water will give you an adherence to get the Fresnel prism stick on. So this Fresnel prism already have a slight adhesive material onto the flat surface. That flat surface will stick onto this particular lens and give it an adhesive form. So the moment you apply water, then you put the Fresnel prism properly and apply some pressure over it, and then it will stick and give you the desired effect. Now in the next slide, we will see how actually it is done. So this is how a Fresnel prism actually looks like. So it is quite flexible. So if you see how thin it is hardly your 1 to 2 mm, maximum it is 1 mm. So if you see here, it is written as base. So this is what is giving you the idea that where is the base. So when I keep it this way, this is base out. So again, we see this is again your base out. So either this way or the above. When I keep it this way, it is your base in. Again, the same thing, base in. So when I place this up, that is called as your base up orientation. And when you take it down, this would be your base down orientation. So if you see here, one side that is your base return and the other side that is your power. So even you can place it obliquely. Now the best part about this prism is you can put it on any axis. So depending on what axis the prism has to be prescribed, it can be easily done. So this is for Fresnel lenses. Now Fresnel lenses are something different. So for that you need to mark the center. So here you take a Fresnel prism. Now if you see there are striations present, put it onto your axis marking chart so that your lens and your Fresnel prism have a complete straight axis and there should not be any deviation into it, or else the desired effect will not be given. The moment you mark it with a marker, then you cut it with a sharp razor and cut it very properly so that it can stick to your frame with perfect shape. Then you apply some water, and then the flat surface of the Fresnel prism is applied onto the back surface and some pressure is applied, and then you can get this particular effect which will give you the Fresnel prism effect. So coming on to the advantages. So what all advantages does Fresnel prism gives me over your traditional prisms? So these are thin and lightweight. So as compared to your traditional prism, which are quite heavy and bulky, your Fresnel prisms are as light and very thin. So it will not add much more weight onto your spectacles. And also they are easy to apply and use. Next is very flexible and easy. So as you saw earlier, depending on whatever shapes of frame you have, you can easily cut out that particular shape and easily stick it onto your lens itself. Next thing is it can be removed and altered. Now the biggest problem with the traditional prism is every time your prismatic power changes or the deviation changes, you need to get a new set of glasses to be done, as the prisms are incorporated within the glasses. Though my refractive power has not changed, but the prisms which are incorporated into it, every time the prism power will change, that has to be changed with the lenses itself. Whereas when there is condition where the prism is altering every few months, so in that circumstances, what you can do, you can use your Fresnel prism, because Fresnel prism can be applied or removed depending on what is your need. So it is easy to apply and easy to remove. So if at all there is a need to change the prismatic power, what you can do is you remove the previous one, cut a new one and paste it. So that is what is the biggest advantage you get in Fresnel prism. Finally, it can be used for your sectoral field. Now when we say about complete prisms, so that prism will act all over my gazes, but many conditions like particular gaze palsies, then hemianopia, in those conditions, what we want the prism to act only in one particular set of areas. Like for example, in hemianopia, I only want it to act onto the half side of my right. So for that reason, your Fresnel prisms are very much usable. So what you can do is you can cut it accordingly and place it so that the patient can only have prism in that certain amount of area. So sectoral prism can be given very beautifully in your Fresnel prism lenses. Coming on to the disadvantages, so if it is so much good, then why don't we give it for every patient? So there are some of the disadvantages associated with it. The first and foremost is appearance. So if you look into this picture, the striated appearance of the lens looks quite different. The one lens is clear, the other one is having a striation, so it gives you a slight different appearance in both the lenses, though it can be overcome with the help of slightly tinted, or what you can say, with the help of your photochromic lenses. The second is difficult to clean. So as you all know, compared to a plain surface, whenever there are grooves on any surface, the dust will get very quickly accumulated and it is quite difficult for you to remove those dust particles, or rather to clean. So that is one of the biggest disadvantages into your Fresnel lenses. Next is reduces vision for higher prism power. So as the prism power increases, there is a slight increase in the thickness as well. So there will be a reduction in your vision because of a PVC sheet which is present. Now PVC sheet is basically the chemical, or rather the composite material, which is used to create this sheet. And finally, it also reduces your contrast. So I'll give you one image. So this is how actually the image should be seen, but because of presence of Fresnel prism, you see it is seen like this. So here what has happened, there is a reduced in your vision as well as the contrast has reduced. So because of the PVC material which is present right before the glass, what happens, the amount of contrast which is coming from the lenses will reduce to 90%, and that 10% of reduction will lead to your lesser vision as well as your lesser contrast. Thank you for giving your precious time and going through this video. I hope it would give you a better understanding about Fresnel prism, its construction, as well as its uses, advantage and disadvantages. Thank you for watching this video again, and please do subscribe our channel, and we will be back with more videos on optometry. Thank you and goodbye.